You know, it's possible to create our own gods and believe it's the real god. But this is not the big problem of idols. Usually, they are made by men to be worshipped by men. But what man has created cannot be bigger than man. If the idol is human work, then man is his creator and not the other way around. In ancient idolatry, it was widely practiced. Each people had their gods, which were some sort of amulet that protected them from the dangers. But the tragedy of trusting in gods created by men is that they cannot do anything. In chapter 21 of the book of Isaiah, the prophet announces the downfall of the great Babylon. The scene depicted shows not only the destruction of the city, but also the inefficacy of its gods. Listen to verses 8 and 9. Then the watchtower shouted like a lion, "Sir, I stand continually on the watchtower in the daytime. I've sat at my post every night. And look, here comes a chariot of men with a pair of horsemen." Then he answered and said, "Babylon is fallen, and all the carved images of our gods he has broken to the ground. And you, what's your god? He is the true God who reveals himself in the Bible. Or is a god that you created from your own ideas?" You know, the Bible is the window that allows us to look at the transcendental and see a little of the true God. In the Bible, you find out about him and what his plans for your life. So every time I read the Bible, I know a little more about the author of the Bible, the creator of everything, the true God.